Good morning, students. Today we will see beam strength and wear strength for bevel gears. That means design of bevel gears. Okay, welcome to for today's session. Learning objective of the today's session. After this session, you will able to discuss the procedure for calculation of beam strength, wear strength, and effective load on bevel gear. And even though by using the same relations, you can find out the module, or you can easily design bevel gears also, or you can easily find out the power transmitting capacity or factor of safety against bending failure and pitting failure. Now let us start with beam strength of bevel gear. You know very well, day before yesterday we have discussed, to have a analysis simple one, we have to make a equivalent, or we have to consider bevel gear equivalent to a formative spur gear. Again, during that session, we have discussed the classification as well as the terms or terminology associated with the bevel gear. Now, today we will see what is the beam strength equation for bevel gear as well as the wear strength equation for bevel gear. And you know very well, in last session also, we have discussed the same thing. Here, the half part of the bevel gear, which is constructed here, half part. Again, here some, you know, the AO is the cone distance, B is the face width, then SB is the, you know, the tangential load which is acting on the gear. But before that, what we have to do, we have to consider here the bevel gear equivalent to formative gear, and for that purpose RB is the, you know, the radius that we are going to use. And last time we have seen, by using that RB, we have constructed one formative or equivalent spur gear. So today we are going to consider this spur gear, that is formative spur gear, which is equivalent to bevel gear. How to carry out the beam strength analysis? For that purpose, look at this. This is the face width, you know, the B is the face width, and it's here from the, you know, the smaller end to up to the larger end. And always we have to take the dimension of large end, we have already discussed last time also. Here to make to derive the equation for beam strength, what we have to do, consider this elemental section having here the, you know, the width dx, and from the apex it is at a distance of x. Look at this, it is at a distance of x. The consider elemental section at a distance of x from the apex. Why we are considering it? Because it varies from this, the smaller end to the larger end, and to have a proper equation, we are going to integrate this distance from smaller to the larger end. That's why consider the smaller end. Consider this dx, or a width dx at a distance of x from the apex. And again, what we have to do? We have to apply the equation of a beam strength, which is applicable to this spur gear, because in this case we are considering, again, you know very well, this is the RB. Suppose what is the radius? This is the RB, and by using that we have constructed here the formative spur gear. Okay, or here it is written formative spur gear at the large end. Then next one, what we have to do for this small element or a section, elemental section, what we have to do? We have to apply the Lewis equation, which is applicable to the spur gear. But that Lewis equation of the spur gear, we are going to apply to this formative spur gear, and again for this elemental section. Okay. And for this elemental section, this, and you know very well, what is the SB for spur gear? The SB is equal to MB sigma B into Y. MB sigma B into Y. So here what you have to do, this is general equation, but we are applying for this small width here. So here it is written SB is equal to MB sigma B into Y, but for this section having a width dx, the del SB is written, because for this elemental section, then module, again suffix x is used, that means module of the section, this section, B again suffix x is used, again is the face width of the elemental section. Okay, then again this bx, you know very well it's a dx actually. You look at this, then sigma b is the bending stress and y is the Lewis form factor. But again here this Lewis form factor based on, it's a formative, that means depends on virtual number of teeth or formative teeth. So this is first step. What we have to do, we have to apply the Lewis equation applicable to the spur gear. We have applied it to the formative spur gear. And for what? For this elemental section, so you will get this equation. Okay, del SB is equal to MX into BX into sigma B into Y, where MX is the model of the section, BX is the face width of the elemental section, sigma B bending stress for that material which is for the bevel gear tooth, and Y is the Lewis form factor depends on virtual number of teeth. Okay, now let us see how to derive it. It's a very simple derivation. Again, you know, the day before yesterday we have seen, or from the figure also we will see now. Okay, look at this here. Even though you can observe here, if we are going to write R upon Rx is equal to, and based on that Rx which is applicable to this, the distance at a x and AO is the cone distance. The AO upon x, you can apply the geometry or similar triangle fundamentals also. R by Rx is equal to AO. This is R means at the large end radius. The AO is the cone distance, and for the element is Rx. So you can say is the x. So R by Rx is equal to AO by x. This is the fundamentals of the geometry. By using these the fundamentals, what you will get, Rx by R is equal to x upon AO. Or you can rearrange it, Rx is equal to x R upon AO. This is from the figure. Then again, you know very well, if we are going to find out the module for the elemental section, so you know very well 2Rx, YRx at elemental radius, and Rx is equal to, you know very well, Mx into Z. The Mx is equal to 2Rx upon Z. Simple formula, Mz, or 2Rx means D, or you can say the Dx also in terms of the PCD of that elemental. So you can use the formula of the module, Mx is equal to 2Rx upon Z. But what is the Rx? Rx is equal to X into capital R by Z. You can substitute this value. Okay, after substituting the value of this, what you will get? 2 into Rx means X into R upon AO. The Mx is equal to this value you will get. And in general, this is for the elemental section, module at the elemental section. If we are going to apply, or we are going to find out the module, and always we have to find out the module at the large end. Yesterday we have discussed this. For a large end, what is the relation? M is equal to 2R by Z, or MZ is equal to 2R is equal to capital D. You know very well this. D means the PCD of the bevel gear. But look at this. M is equal to, if I am going to write here, M is equal to 2R by Z. But here, what is 2R by Z is equal to M? Look at this, here 2, here R, and here is also Z. That means you can substitute this M, X is equal to 2R by Z means this M. M into, again what you will get, X, and what is remaining at the denominator? So you will get here AO. So what you will get, MX is equal to here M into X upon AO. Try to understand this value. So by using this geometry of the bevel gear and using the relation of the module at the elemental section and at the large end, we can easily find out MX is equal to M in bracket X upon AO. That you have to remember. This is one equation. Then second, if you are going to refer the earlier figure, you will find here what is the face width here, b for the small element, it's a dx. So you can write b is equal to dx because we are calculating the sb for the elemental section. Now let us see what we have to do here. Again, therefore bx is equal to dx is written, and you know the formula, del sb is equal to mx into bx into sigma b into y. So what you have to do, you can substitute the value of mx is equal to M into X upon AO, and BX is equal to DX. In which equation? The simple equation, del SB is equal to, again I am writing, MX into BX into sigma B into Y. In this equation, you have to put MX is equal to this, M in this relation. BX means DX. So what you will get? You will get this formula. I have highlighted it. Look at this here. So del SB is equal to M into X upon AO, that is MX. Then what is here DX? DX is nothing but a BX and Y into sigma B. Simple one. So after that, you will get this, and I have written it as a part two or equation two, and this is part one because we are going to use it. Then what we have to do, you can multiply this Rx into del SB, Rx into del SB. I have written here. Look at this, Rx into del SB, Rx into del SB. And again, why we are integrating it, you know, because we have determined this SB beam strength at the elemental section, but for the gear, we have considered only the elemental section here, this having the width del X or DX. But we have to find out the beam strength of this, we will get to. That's why we have to integrate it. The integrating R into del SB. And again, R del SB is nothing but a torque. F into R, you know very well, it's a torque. So first of all, do the multiplication R into del SB. And why we are integrating? To have a overall effect on the bevel gear tooth. Again, second, substitute the value of Rx. What is the value of Rx here? You know very well, Rx is equal to X into R upon, you can substitute here, X into R upon AO. Then what is the value of del SB? You have calculated M into sigma B into Y into X into DX upon AO. The AO, AO becomes AO square. Then X into this X, X square. Again, here it is written integration of X square into DX, and M is the constant model, sigma B for the material based on this bending stress is 50 by 3. Y Lewis form factor depends on the virtual number of teeth and the large end radius. You can put all these values and rearrange the equation in this way. Again, but del SB into Rx is nothing but a torque F into R. That's why instead of writing this term, here it is written as a MT. Now, let us see here. This MT is equal to, this is the some constants, and then again here you have to use the limit. Limit it varies from AO minus B to AO means cone distance. Look at this diagram, you will find AO from this end to up to this you have to reach. So how much is this distance? This is B. Up to this distance, when you are going to calculate AO minus B, this, and this is up to this, this is AO. So you can put this limit here in the formula, and that's why in integration, this limit is shown. Look at this, AO minus B to max up to AO at the large end, X square. Again, you can take the integration X cube by 3. Again, you can substitute the limit. Substituting these values, what you will get here? Look at this. It's a very simple analysis. So you will get MT is equal to MB into sigma B into Y into R in bracket 1 after substituting the limiting values of the integration, higher side and lower side, 1 minus B upon AO plus B square upon this value you will get. But again here, you know very well, what is MT? MT is equal to SB into R. So you can substitute here, or here MT is equal to SB into R here. Look at this. This is MT. I am going to write SB into R, and R from this side, suppose if I am going to write here SB into R means MT is equal to this term, remaining term. The R of this side gets cancelled, this R gets cancelled. What is remaining? M into B into sigma B into Y, and remaining inside bracket this term, which is remains same here. So you will get SB is equal to this term. Try to understand. Then again, very interesting and important point here. So what is happening? Face width is limited to 1/3 of the cone distance. 1/3 of the, why 1/3 of the cone distance? Because while transmitting the load or a force, we have to take into account this cone distance, face width. And that's why 1/3 of the cone distance, face width is limited, which is helpful, or 1/3 of the cone distance. That means this face width, which is going to transmit the torque or a load which is coming on the bevel gear tooth. That's why 1/3 of the cone distance. And if we are going to take into account this 1/3 of the cone distance, 1/3 of the cone distance, so what will happen? This term B if you are going to put one third of B is equal to one third of the cone distance, that is AO, and if you are going to solve, you will find this last term, it is not more than 1/27, and the 1/27, that means you will get point not something, point not 3, like this. And this is very, very small. That's why we have to neglect this term, last term. And neglecting this term, what is remaining? SB is equal to MB into sigma B into Y. And only we are going to take into account first 1 minus B upon A0. We have neglected this term. Its value is very, very small. So this equation, you will obtain this equation. And this equation, SB is equal to MB into sigma b into y, it's like a spurrier, only this term is added here in multiplication, in bracket 1 minus b upon a0, and this equation is nothing but a beam strength equation for a bevel gear. Very simple one, try to understand. And where sb is the beam strength, m is the module, b is the base width, sigma b is the permissible stress, again sc to y3, y is the Lewis form factor, depends on the formative or virtual number of teeth. And AO is the cone distance. And yesterday we have seen how to find out the cone distance. AO is equal to under root dp by 2 bracket square plus dg by 2 bracket square. You can easily find out this. And again here, this term 1 minus b upon AO is also called as Bevel factor. Try to understand. Is also known as Bevel factor. So you remember this equation of SB for a bevel gear. This is one part of this session. Beam strength, try to understand. Okay, that means beam strength of the bevel gear depends on this module, base width, sigma b, y, along with this AO, cone distance is also going to play important role, or bevel factor is there. Okay, this is about the beam strength. Again, this beam strength we have to calculate, and you know very well, in many times we have discussed in spur gear design, helical design, what is the beam strength? It is the maximum value of tangential force that tooth can transmit without bending failure. But why calculating the tangential force? Always we have to calculate it is at the large end of the bevel gear to try to understand in this case. That's why I have highlighted this word, at the large end of the tooth. This is the beam strength of the bevel gear. And again, large, that means we have to find out the tangential force at the large end. And how to calculate this tangential force? Pt is equal to 2mt upon d. Mt is the torque transmitted, d is the circle diameter of the bevel gear, and you will get the pt. This is one important thing. Then how to obtain the value of face width? And day before yesterday we have decided what is the range for the face width in case of the bevel gear. But if you don't know, always you have to take face width, b is equal to 10 times the module. It's like a spur gear or a 0 by 3, whichever is smaller. You can note down this point. The face width of the bevel gear B is equal to 10 times module or a 0 by 3, one third of the cone distance, whichever is smaller. While solving the problem, you can use 10 times module. In if a0 is known, or you can calculate a 0 by 3, and whichever is smaller, that value you have to consider it as a B in your calculation. You can note down and write down there. Okay, this is about the beam strength equation. Now let us see another very important failure of the bevel gear, that is fitting failure or wear strength of bevel gear. Okay, now in this case, what we have to do, we have to find out the fitting failure of the bevel gear. Now let us see again in bevel gear also. When bevel pinion and bevel gear, when they are missing while transmitting the motion or a power, there is a line contact. Which type of contact is there? There is a line contact. And this line contact, it's like a spur gear. And again, to make the analysis simple one, again, what we have to do in consideration? Consider bevel gear is equivalent to the formative spur gear, already discussed many times. Okay. So what we have to do? We have to apply the Buckingham's equation to the formative spur gear. Try to understand. And how to apply? You know very well what is the SW for spur gear? P into Q into dp into K. This equation. This is the equation of a spur gear. And we are applying this Buckingham's equation. or a wear strength equation of spur gear to the formative gear. How to apply it? Look at this. Day before yesterday, we have discussed RB is the radius, and if we are going to consider this angle ABC or angle BCA, the AB upon AC, and again sine gamma is the pitch angle, you know very well, the sine 90 minus D by 2 upon RB. And if you are going to find out the RB, RB is equal to D upon 2 cos gamma, and again DP, you know very well here for the pitch, that is 2 RB radius. We have discussed this thing, the same thing I have used once again in this slide. Okay, so just why it is important, because V face width is equal to 10 times modulo or A0Y3, Q, K and DP, that we have to check, and what are their values that we are going to substitute here. But again, very important thing here, this DP, pitch circle diameter of the pinion, is going to change. How it is going to change? Look at this. RB is equal to, from this figure, RB is equal to D upon 2 cos gamma. But what is DP? DP is equal to 2 into RB. You can substitute this value here. If I am going to substitute, DP is equal to 2 into RB. What is RB? RB is equal to capital D upon what? 2 into cos gamma. 2 into cos gamma. Gamma is the pitch angle. 2 to get cancelled. So what you will get? DP is equal to D upon cos gamma. So I have written here, this is okay. Don't consider that. DP is equal to DP upon cos gamma. So what you have to do? You have to substitute this value in wear strength equation of spur gear. So you can substitute DP is equal to this DP upon cos gamma here. Okay. And by substituting this value, what you will get? SW is equal to V into Q into DP, means DP upon this cos gamma, DP upon cos gamma into this. This is the SW equation you will get. Again, what is happening? Very interesting. Look at this. We have modified this equation. So here in the case of the bevel gears, again, generally you will find this is suppose bevel pinion, which meshes with this bevel gear here, and it transmits, this is the axis, it transmits power at 90 degree. But here, this pinion or a bevel gear may be in hanging position like a cantilever one, and because of that, the face width of this bevel gear only 3/4, try to understand, 3/4 of the face width is effective to transmit the tangential or to transmit the load in case of bevel gear. And if 3/4 is the effective, that's why. So we have to consider this effectiveness in terms of face width. 3/4. So that's why 0.75. We are going to multiply by this equation by 0.75 into B. The SW is equal to 0.75 into this equation remains same. B into K into DP into K upon cos gamma. And you will get modified equation here. Look at this. This SW is equal to 0.75 B into Q into DP into K upon cos gamma. And this equation is known as Buckingham's equation for wear strength of bevel gear, or simply wear strength equation applicable to bevel gear. Try to understand. 0.75 V into Q into DP into K upon cos gamma. This is about the wear strength equation. Why the 0.75? Only 3/4 of the face width is effective because of this. It's a hanging position of the maybe bevel pinion or the gear. That's why to consider this 3/4 effectiveness, multiplying by 0.75. Okay, this is about the wear strength. But in this equation, another terms are there. B, you know, 10 times modulo or A0/3, whichever is smaller, Q is the ratio factor, DP the PCD of the pinion, and K is the material constant associated with the load and stress, that we have to find out. How to find out the Q, ratio factor, and the K, we will say in K. Gamma is the pitch angle of the pinion. Now let us see ratio factor. How to find out this ratio factor? Here, for this purpose, okay, the ratio factor, you know, it depends on again formative number of teeth, like a helical gear, Q is equal to 2 zg dash upon zg plus zp. But again, for a bevel gear, you know very well, zp dash is equal to, remember this formula, very important, zp dash is equal to zp upon cos gamma. Gamma is the pitch angle. Pitch angle is the pitch line makes angle with the axis. Zp means number of teeth on pinion. This gamma is the pitch, angle, and ZP dash means virtual number of teeth on pinion. Similarly, virtual number of teeth on gear, ZZ is ZG dash is equal to ZG upon cos big gamma. And again, yesterday we have seen this big gamma is equal to 90 minus gamma, and you will get ZG upon sin gamma. You can remember this equation, and ZG dash is equal to ZG upon sin gamma. Okay, then what you have to do? You have to substitute these values here to ZG dash. ZG dash means this ZG upon sin gamma, and ZP means ZP upon cos gamma. After substituting, you can find out here the cos gamma and sin gamma, you will get the tan gamma term. The Q is equal to 2 ZG upon ZG plus ZP into tan gamma. This is the ratio factor. So while calculating the SB, SW is equal to, you know, B points, first of all, 0.7 pi U into B into Q into DP into K upon cos gamma, where Q, that is the ratio factor, is equal to 2 ZG upon ZG plus ZP. This formula you have to use for the ratio factor. Then what is the value of K? It's a material constants or a load stress factor, depends on the sigma C, AP, and modulus of elasticity of the material is for the AP, which is same like a spur gear, same equation we can use. And generally, bevel gears are made up of a steel material. For a steel material, again, alpha is the pressure angle. You can substitute 20 degree. How much? 20 degree pressure angle, AP and EZ for the steel material. After substituting these values, you will get K is equal to 0.16. And this equation is applicable for the spur gear as well as for the helical gear also, when the pinion and gears are made up of steel. The K is equal to 0.16 BH, and same equation you can use in the equation of wear strength. Only the wear strength equation is the different than the, and what is this equation? I am going to once again show to you. This is 0.75 B into Q into DP into K. The K is equal to 0.16 in bracket BH and upon 100 bracket square. What is Q? That is the different one, 2 ZG upon ZG plus ZP tan gamma. But that is the difference. So you can substitute, you can find out the SW. Then once you have a SB and SW, how to find out the effective load on the gear tooth? Again, very simple one. To find out the effective load, so you should first calculate the PT. How to calculate the tangential component? From the power, if KW means the power is given, P is equal to, you know very well, it's very simple one. 2 into pi into N into MT upon 60. You, by using this equation, you will get the MT is the torque. The MT is equal to this equation, NP is the speed of the pinion. And P, once you know the MT torque, you can easily find out the tangential force. Okay, that is PT is equal to 2MT upon D. This is, you have to remember, you know very well this equation. Many times you use in spur and helical gear. Again, you know, we have to find out the effective load, because to avoid the failure of the gear to bending, the SB, bending strength or beam strength, should be greater than P effective. This is a relation. And again, SB is equal to P effective into SB. We have used many times this equation in design of spur and helical gear. And to avoid the pitting failure or wear failure, SW should be, it's not like a for a SW beams wear strength, it means pitting failure. The SW should be greater than P effective. So you can write SW is equal to P effective into a post. But what is the value of P effective? The, you know very well, P effective is equal to CSPT upon CV, and P effective is equal to CSPT plus PD, these two equations. And we can easily obtain these two equations by using two methods, you know very well. 1 minute. Okay. So there are two methods to account for the dynamic load, and we have used these two methods in case of design of spur gear as well as the helical gear. Once again, within 2 minutes, I will recap these methods. Approximate estimation by velocity factor, and second, Buckingham's equation or dynamic to calculate the dynamic load. Let us consider the first equation by using velocity factor. In this case, again, Barth or a velocity factor that you have to use, approximate estimation. Like a spur gear, okay, but only in spur gear The velocity factor depends on the pitch line velocity, whether pitch line velocity less than 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, more than 20, greater than 20 or 30, like this. And different formulas or relations of CVs are available. But in case of, you know, helical gear, only one equations available for helical gear, CV is equal to 5.6 upon 5.6 plus under root V. But in case of bevel gear, two relations for velocity factors are available. And these velocity factors depends on manufacturing method, whether bevel gears are cut teeth. Velocity factor for cut teeth, that means related to manufacturing, and velocity factor for generated teeth. Two methods are used to manufacture the bevel gears. Based on that, which velocity factor we have to use in the calculation. So you can write down the velocity factor for cut teeth. If teeth are cut, the CV is equal to 6 upon 6 plus V. This equation we have to use. V is the pitch line velocity, and we can easily find out 0.8 by 60. I have used into 10 raised to 3 because V is always in meter per second. That's why to convert it into, it is multiplied by 10 raised to 3. Okay. But when the teeth generated teeth, the velocity factor you have to use 5.6 upon 5.6 plus root V. This equation applicable to helical gear also. For generated and cut, so while solving the problem, you have to read the problem statement carefully, because in statement it is written bevel gears are cut teeth or generated teeth, and accordingly you are going to decide the value of CV, which formula you are going to use in the your equations. Okay, this is about cut teeth and about generated, two relations only for bevel gear. You have to decide whether cut teeth or generated, accordingly you can select CV, then pitch line velocity. And once you have a CV, for according to the preliminary stages of design using the velocity factor, how to calculate the P effective? CS into PT upon CV is this, from this formula, or maybe this CS service factor, PT is the tangential load, and you know very well how to calculate the tangential load. Then next one, precise calculation by bucking sums equation you can give. It's again very simple. In final stages of gear design, we have to calculate the dynamic load by using bucking sums equation. Again, after calculating the dynamic load, we can use this formula. P effective is equal to CSPT plus PD. And how to calculate PT? You know, from the torque and the power, CS service factor, and PD is the dynamic load from the Buckingham's equation. Again, I have written the same equation which is used for the spur gear. Try to understand. PD is equal to 21V in bracket C into E into B plus PT upon 21V plus under root CEB plus PT. Where, what is C? Deformation factor, Newton per mm square. If this value is not given, 11,400, that you have to consider. Then E is the error on pinion and gear, EP plus EG. B is the face weight, PT is the tangential force, and PV is the pitch line velocity. Here I have mentioned, but one thing very important I have highlighted, here some of the errors of two meshing teeth. Here in spur gear and the helical gear, this is the equation of spur gear which is applicable to the bevel gear. Try to understand. But in case of helical gear, the cos gamma plays the important role, helix angle plays the important role. That's why this equation is different. It's okay. But what is, how to obtain this, some of the errors between the two meshing teeth? In spur gear, what we have done, we have used the equation EP is equal to A plus 0.25, you know, the different equations we have used based on the different grades of the gear, and total 1 to 12 grades of different manufacturing methods decide the different grades of the gears, and that is used in case of spur gear. But in this case, it's very difficult to obtain that data. Try to understand how to obtain. Then remember this one thing, how to, you don't use this, the relations used for the spur and helical gear to obtain the error. Here what we have to do, then question arises, how to calculate the error between two meshing teeth? For bevel gear, it's very difficult to obtain the empirical relations for like a spur and helical. That's why don't use these relations. That's why always while designing the gear, to find out the error or manufacturing error, always you have to contact the manufacturer, and by using their data you can find out the error, or you can take into your account into calculations. But If this data is not available and no need to each time to contact the manufacturer, that's why bevel gears are classified into here three classes based on the manufacturing method. One is class one, that is well cut commercial gear. Second, class two, gear teeth cut with great care. And class three, ground and lap precision. You know, in case of spur and helical, 1 to 12 gears are given, and based on that we have to find out the values of EP and EZ. Then submission of EP, EZ will get the error. But in this case, don't use these relations. Directly contact to the bevel gear manufacturer and take the error from them, and you can put in your formula. Otherwise, if you don't have a data of that manufacturer, then what you have to do? We have to use this approach that I have shown on this slide. The gears are classified into class one, class two, class three. Class one means well cut commercial, class two gear tip cut with great care, and class three ground and lap precision gear. And here, based on the model, the value of the errors for class one, class two, class three are given. Suppose model up to four, if in the problem it is mentioned gear or well cut and commercial gear teeth, so you have to take this value if model is up to four. If it is mentioned gear cut with great care, that means class two, but model is six, you can select this value. And if it's a class three, lapped and precision means very, you know, the surface finish is very high, good quality here. That is class three. And if model is eight, then you have to take this value. That means you have to refer the chart or a table to take the value of E. And these values are E value. Directly you can use this value and substitute in the PD. PD means year. And you will get the PD, you can substitute, you will get the PE peak to try to understand. This is about the wear strength as well as the beam strength of bevel gear. Thank you. I have referred Vivek Bhandari's book, Design of Machine Element. Okay.